Hey guys, welcome back to Topic Tuesday. Today's topic will be compatibility. I'm joined here by my colleague Otto Soidensalo, who will help us understand this a little bit further. So Otto, we have this cellulosic fibrils, which is forming a three-dimensional structure. And we know that these have a lot of OH groups, and they're compatible with water-based systems. But what about other systems?
Well, that's actually a question that we get quite often. So people, of course, think that we sell the product in water, that it's water compatible. But actually, you can use it in many organic solvents. Mm. So I would say that the major things are that you need to have a polar solvent. Mm. The solvent needs to be water miscible. Mm. And usually the polar, the better.
So what type of polar systems are you used to discuss with the people that's testing this type of products?
So normally we alcohols are typical, yep. Ethanol, methanol.
Yep.
Those you can easily go up to 50%.
Mm-hmm.
On the other hand, if you use, for example, glycols, propylene glycol,
yep.
There you can easily go up to 90%. And especially the glycols or glycol ethers are interesting because there you also see synergy. So actually you get higher performance. So you can clearly see that the viscosity is increasing,
mm-hmm.
which then gives you higher performance, more stable system.
Mm-hmm. So Otto, why is this compatibility important?
So this of course enables you to use Exilva, so not only in water, but you can also thicken your solvent-borne system. So mm-hmm. think about coatings based on alcohols or other solvents. So actually you are able to cover the whole range, starting from the waterborne, going to the solvent-borne systems.
So even if cellulose fibrils is delivered mostly as a water-based product or a hydrophilic product, there's big opportunities also in other systems.
Correct.
Guys, as a download now, we actually have a new technical bulletin on the subject, but what can we learn there, Otto?
So we have tested several common solvents, so you will see how Exilva behaves in these solvents, and it also gives you the instructions how to do it if you want to repeat it in your lab.